Windows, the most common computer virus ever known. Just kidding. I think most of us do use Windows every single day, and if you've ever browsed through your main drive on your computer, you will have probably noticed the Windows folder, or even gone digging around in there. This directory is where all the core system files of the operating system are stored, including that infamous System32 folder, and more. Now, I made a video in the past to figure out what would happen if you delete System32, but I wanted to know what would happen if you delete the entire Windows directory. But not only that, I want to do it while Windows is running. What fun would that be otherwise? I'm expecting it will at least freeze up at some point, or maybe even blue screen. We'll see, it should be fun. First though, I want to mention the sponsor of this video, privacy.com, which is a free service that allows you to create virtual payment cards you can use to buy things online instead of using your real credit card info, therefore protecting your personal and banking information. You can learn more by going to privacy.com/TheoJoe, and for a limited time, you'll get a free $5 credit you can use on your first purchase. So you can also click that same link right in the description. And now, let's get started. So we can already assume that deleting the Windows directory will cause some major issues, to say the least, probably causing the system to freeze or crash. But let's see how much we can get away with and observe any weird behavior before it does, and then see if there's any way we could possibly recover from such destruction. To get some context, let's quickly go over some of the more important folders in here. That way we can maybe hold off on those and do them last to delete as much as possible. Obviously, we mentioned System32, which has possibly the most critical system files, not just for Windows itself, but also third-party programs with things like shared libraries. There's also a drivers folder in there for hardware devices. And another important folder is the SysWOW64 folder, which is similar to System32, but for 32-bit DLLs. The WinSXS folder is another critical folder which stores DLLs and library components and is used by many programs at once. Not all of them are critical, but many are. On Microsoft's own website, it even says, warning, deleting the files from the WinSXS folder or deleting the entire WinSXS folder may severely damage your system so that your PC might not boot and make it impossible to update. Now that's what I'm talking about. Then there's plenty of other ones that sound important that we can mess around with, like system resources, system apps, and boot. Now obviously it's normally impossible to actually delete the Windows directory and really any folder within it because it's protected by permissions. But with enough effort, you can force yourself to get those permissions and be able to delete anything you want, as long as it's not actively being used by a running program. Also, because this will clearly ruin any Windows installation you try it on, I'll be doing this with a virtual machine, but it should still behave the same. So, enough chatting, let's get into this. Alright, so now we're inside Windows, and we can just start trashing everything, basically. And I noticed there are still some permission issues, so I can clear that up real quick. And most of these folders are going down no problem. There is some stuff that can't be deleted while it's being used, even with permissions though, but that's not everything. Of course, we do have to make sure we delete all the actual files in the Windows folder, not just things that are in folders themselves. And testing out some stuff, it looks like the start menu and taskbar at least still do work for now. And then at this point, it looks like a ton of the folders are gone except for the ones we couldn't delete completely. So let's see what we can do about the SysWOW64 folder. And I'll just select a big chunk, and it seems to have no problem deleting almost all of that. So let's see if we can just delete all the files, and it looks like a good amount got deleted, and we'll come back to that one, I think. Next, let's check out that WinSXS folder, which has a ton of stuff in it. I just literally select everything in there and try to delete it. And this one is clearly gonna take a while. You can see it says there's like 13,000 items or something. It's ridiculous. So yeah, that's gonna take a while. So we can see how much stuff is broken in the meantime. And it looks like the start menu still works, but the system seems to be slowing down a lot, probably just from trying to delete so many files right now. And I can still open Explorer windows, that seems fine. But when I do try to open settings like the personalized menu or whatever, it just brings up an error, it can't do that. The task manager still works, probably because we haven't touched the System32 folder yet where that is, but it does freeze a bit. You know there's a problem when the task manager itself stops responding. I mean, what do you do then? Now the taskbar itself seems to work, but nothing else on it really works. Like searching doesn't work, clicking the clock doesn't do anything. I'm actually surprised at this point that Windows itself is still running and hasn't totally crashed. So now I think it's time we start deleting System32, and I'll just select all the files and see what it will let me delete, and then we can go back into the SysWOW64 and make sure we didn't miss anything there. System32 seems to have a lot of stuff that we can't delete because it's in use, but a lot of it is gone. So if you go to the start menu, for example, a lot of the admin tools are gone. You can see it's just not showing their icons at all, it's blank. So now let's get into some of these directories that wouldn't let us delete outright, and then go inside and delete some of the folders from within. Like system apps here, it actually let me delete a lot more in there. And then the system resources doesn't even have too much left anymore either. And now I'm just seeing what we can delete in more of these folders. There's a surprising amount that we can delete that we couldn't from the top level folders. And it looks like even all the fonts are gone too. And now it looks like we can still open new Explorer windows, but nothing else from the start menu works. So no settings menus or anything. Nothing happens when you click on them. Though it seems like we can actually create some new files and folders, interestingly. And just poking around on the desktop, things don't really feel or look any different, except that nothing opens when you click on it, obviously. But otherwise, most of the Windows components must be running and still loaded in memory, so that's why it still is running itself. If we do take a look in the recycle bin, we can see that I deleted over 19,000 items, which is pretty insane. And now that we've basically deleted everything we can, I think, we can try and restart, see if it'll even let us, and then see what it says when we do that. But before we do that, let me tell you about today's sponsor. Privacy.com is a free service I've actually been using for years. It basically lets you create unique virtual payment cards you can use to buy things online. One type of virtual card you can create is a so-called burner card, which only works once, so you don't have to worry about it being stolen. And the other type of card is a merchant card, which will essentially be locked to the first place you use it. So even if it gets stolen, it can't be used anywhere else. There are also other features you probably won't see with any other regular credit card, such as being able to set spending limits for single charges or time frames, so you'll never be surprised by an accidental double charge or price increase without your consent. They also have a Chrome extension, making it easy to automatically create and remember cards for specific websites. And there's also a smartphone app so you can get notifications for spending, for example. And actually, if you sign up now for a limited time, you can get a $5 credit to spend on your first purchase by going to privacy.com/TheoJoe. So yes, it's a free service and you're getting a free credit. You'll just need to attach a bank account or debit card so that you can actually pay for things. So be sure to check that link in the description. And now let's continue. At first, it looked like it was not going to actually even let me restart the computer. It wasn't really responding when I clicked it, but surprisingly, it did begin to restart. And then it tries to start an automatic repair, not sure how much it will be able to do there. And I like how it does say, diagnosing your PC, like, maybe it's because we deleted the entire operating system. And no surprise here at all, the automatic repair does not work. So it takes me to another menu where it offers some options, and we can go through some of these troubleshooting options though, see what happens. I do try to boot in safe mode through that setting, but it just brings me back to the same start repair and it keeps looping. And I go to the system restore, but that also doesn't work. There's no system restore points. And then even selecting reset this PC, which normally is like a complete restart and reinstallation, sort of, it just says there was a problem resetting your PC, doesn't even let you do that. So at this point, this whole Windows installation is just stuck in a boot loop and is completely done. So when all was said and done, really the only surprise with all this, for me at least, is the fact that Windows kept running at all. I was expecting it to freeze up or blue screen or something, but it didn't. But of course, after restarting, it was completely finished. So again, I want to thank privacy.com for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check out privacy.com/TheoJoe for that $5 credit for a limited time. And if you want to keep watching, I made a couple other similar videos, like what happens if you delete System32. You can check that out by just clicking on that thumbnail here. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.